What's up, everybody? This is Marnick from Stand Up Company. And when we're talking about storytelling, transferring messages, it's not only about what we say, but also about how we say it, how we use our eyes, our body, our tone of voice to transfer that message. And it will make a big impact on how people will experience that message and which emotions you trigger when they're hearing your story. Now, to make it simple, there are two ways to approach a situation, a message, a story, whatever you want to call it. And that's one, you take a distance from that message. We call that dissociating, taking some time away from the message, looking at it factually. And the second one is really linking yourself, associating yourself with the situation, with your story, and really being in there fully emotionally linked. Now, it might sound a bit fluffy and blurry, dissociating, associating, but I'll give you an example for what I mean, and you will see you will need both. You might tend to prefer dissociating, associating as you are as a person, but a great storyteller will need both. And you will see in the example I'm going to give you now what emotional differences there are, not only in just what I'm saying, but how I'm saying it and how it changes the mood within the story. An example I want to give you, it's now January when I'm taping this video. January is most of the time, even virtually now in this COVID times, it's the time that people give speeches and motivate employees to go into the new year and spread out the new strategies and plans and visions for the future. So I'll pretend to give a speech and really focus on dissociating, associating to show you what it does to the message. So here we go. What's up, everybody? I'm super excited to see you all here. All these familiar faces coming back from the holidays, ready for 2021. Welcome to the new year. And I promise you one thing, it's gonna be our year. Because if I look at the strategy and the plans on the table that I'm gonna present to you, I will show you that we are ready to rock it. But saying that, we can't forget what happened last year. 2021 was probably one of the most challenging years for our generation. We had to say goodbye to people in the company that we didn't want to say goodbye to. Some people lost family or friends and their family due to COVID. But also professionally, clients had to cut their budgets, profits were down. We all had to work at home and a single hug was far away. And even though that was tough, we managed together to reinvent ourselves, to find motivation, and to look at things that we could do better and be ready for the future. And because we did that, we now have a solid foundation. And even though we cannot forget what happened and we cannot forget the colleagues we had to say goodbye to, we are more than ready to reinvent ourselves. We are more than ready to take 2021 and make it our year. Because like I said, if I look at all the faces that I'm seeing here today, I see a team that is ready to take the next step. We will take those learnings, use that foundation as a stepping stone, and we'll make sure that 2021 will be our year. Now, this story is just something I made up on the spot, so it's not as important as what I'm saying in the story, but I hope you notice the difference in voice, in movement, and how all those things together change the emotion and how you experience the random words that I was saying. Now, if you saw the slower, the lower voice, the smaller movements in one piece, that's the dissociating part. I took distance and I took my time to talk about a certain part, only give the facts, making sure that people all could follow and hear my low, slow voice with the small movements. And that all together combined, psychologically, subconscious, is experienced by people as, I need to listen more closely. I am being convinced. This is really important to listen to. Now, if you see the first part of the story and also the last part, what I ended with, I was making bigger movements. My voice went higher, it went faster, I gave more details, I added more emotion and more color to my story. And subconsciously, people experience that as being inspired. I have to go with it. He's sucking me into the story. He's excited. I should be excited. Where is this going? It's inspiration. It's associating yourself with what was happening. The more you associate, the more association your audience will have with you. And you saw, we're using both of them. There's no right order. It depends on what message you are giving and which parts are linked to dissociating, associating parts. But putting them together will make a very entertaining, impactful, convincing, and inspiring story. Now, if you decide I'm only going to do dissociating, I'm only going to do low, slow voice, only facts, that story in the end will be very boring. and will lose the attention, and people will have a harder time keeping the connection with you and what you're saying. If you are too associated and you're only, "What's up, everybody? This is excited," and you're too much, too many details, people will lose structure. They will no longer be able to follow. It will be too much. And in the end, people are like, "Well, he was super happy and excited about something, or super sad, but I can't remember what. And well, I'll just forget it." So you will always need both. And if you manage both, look at any TED Talk, any great speech from Barack Obama to whoever you admire is able to talk in a very, very impactful way. They will always combine both of them. And you can do both of them. Because I will ask you about your plan, about your budget, you will immediately dissociate and give me the facts. Talk lower, slower, because you want me to focus. You do that automatically. If I ask you about your weekend, and if you had, of course, in your little bubble, you had a barbecue or something, you will go in association because the barbecue was fun and it was great and you want to suck me into that moment you had on that Saturday. You will associate by nature. Now think about that consciously. Even go back to my speech and see what happens and try it yourself. And next time you build a story, whatever it is, meeting, speech, presentation, doesn't matter. Try to focus on which parts should I dissociate and which part should I associate. Combine those and you will see no matter what you say, it will have twice the impact because you're also focusing on how you say it. Now, if you want to know more, you guessed it. It's in the book, Stand Up to Stand Out, Expressing Yourself in the Most Powerful Way, Chapter 2. There you will see associating, dissociating with some exercises so you can practice at home and use it as a manual for your future stories. And remember, I always talk about being pumped, your energy. When you're pumped, you trust yourself. And I will never tell you how to move, even though you think that, because I was talking about talking lower, slower, moving bigger, smaller. But your body will know what to do. And if you trust yourself and have the right energy and just focus on your story, where you want to link yourself and where you don't want to link yourself, your voice, your movement, your eyes, and everything you do will be authentic to you and will adapt itself if you let it. Master both and you will master the art of storytelling.